did you come through as pure gold? You kick it like the benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on Rap a Lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. Listen, I went and got my digits up. Listen, your favorite, bruh. Listen, you don't want no trouble, cuh. The 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real Rap a Lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip a in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The lying to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red Dog has caught me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend, homie. Chalked it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a, but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart, he found forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got on, I paid him back and told him it was ugly. I'd rather ask forgiveness like 100 times than be asking for permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I been, check out how I tend to mine. I got a partner who don't eat no poke at dinner time. But let you act like you gon' ever hurt or injure mine. He have your woman, and that's my dinner time. I keep my eyes on glory till the devil get behind. Now bear in mind the devil made me offers I decline. We not aligned, not combined, I am not confined to any wicked system that these demons have designed. They frame a mind and have you salty as a bacon rind. I'm trying to mastermind how to help out humankind. I'm open mind, but I do not rock with none aligned. My state of mind is to keep a peace for peace of mind. I'm like Malcolm with my peace at the Venetian blinds. I'm trying to manifest some things in my subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams in my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, spring to mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is pre-designed. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a toy. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework, I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chiller, click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling.
Get it crisscrossed. Get it.
against me, that's a big love. Yeah. You about to find out what the call. Yeah. I find then I get low. Lift off. It ain't nothing to cut the off. Stop frying, don't let it get soft. Covered in yolk, in yolk. Wonder why I got the whole world pissed off. That's how I'm feeling. Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
Back again up in this. Entertain it for you. Come for my M's, you get this double, double. You're bubble in this game because I love the trouble. So watch your tone if you don't want to rumble. You pop, pop, like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real, real, so stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud, ooh, jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons rang, yes, them cannons rang. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you late. Having some fun, why you out on your run? Taking victory, relax. I'm in the hood with them ones. Catch me out in Decatur with some meat and potatoes. Waffle House in Atlanta, I hit the blue flame later. With them two-tone gates, who you know gon' face? I see them keep trying, professional imitators. Rep, where's the flag? Now you're making me mad. With 47, get that. You better get back. Like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real, real. So stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud. Ooh, jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons rang, yes, them cannons rang. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same. You fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same.
Slipping away. Now I got it, so I bought. start coming in lakes. Lakes. I drive the Rari through the tunnel. Tunnel. I need a passport. I'm riding for in place. Place, place, place. I ain't never had no money. I've been out here trying to get me away. Away. Ain't nobody helping. I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I bought. I used to email the venues and ask them if I could be opening an act for the rappers that's passing through town. I used to be the one kids in my city was laughing about. I used to envision everything happening now. I used to ride the bus and listen to Kendrick Lamar. He just liked the video that I made back when I started to study his bars. I'd like to think that he probably related to someone that's come so far. To someone that wanted it badly, then when it got it and turned to a star. Overly dedicated, a title that resonated. I wanna be recognized, I wanna be decorated. Truthfully, back then I couldn't imagine a life where I never made it. Go ahead and let them hate it, let them hate it.
I ain't never had no money. I've been out here trying to get me away. Ain't nobody helping, I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I bought it.
Madden Football is the home of the Super Bowl, and this historic matchup is brought to you by EA Sports. It's the Panthers and the reigning Super Bowl champs, coming up next.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion Denver Broncos taking on the champions from the NFC, the Carolina Panthers. Brandon Gordon along with Charles Davis, and what a season it's been for our AFC champions. I mean, this was a fight just to get to the Super Bowl. You got to figure that they are very battle-tested and ready.
I'd agree with you 100% about that. You don't get there without having those types of attributes, and that's what you look for in a Super Bowl team. Character, confidence. These guys don't lack for either one of those. Now they're here. Now they're ready to win.
Meanwhile, our NFC champions, they have gone through a lot to get where they are. Everybody knows their story this season. What's the key for them as they start this Super Bowl?
Let's go full cliche on this one because it works. Remember what got you here. Been a winning formula all season long. This is a team that when we saw them in the preseason, we said they look like a group that has what it takes to be a Super Bowl winning team. And we've been proven right by what we've seen throughout the season.
To speak of, call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26. You look at this Super Bowl, the second appearance for this head coach. The first one did not go as planned, as we all know, but what do you think he's learned from that first go around?
He learned how much it hurts to lose, and that's what you hear from coaches so often. They don't remember the wins as much as they remember the losses. You can talk about the media, the scrutiny, the hoopla, but once you've had to shake a head coach's hand and jog off the field and know you have to face the media, face your fans, face your home life, knowing that you've lost the Super Bowl, that hurts big time, and you're going to do everything possible to try and prevent that from happening again.
He's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Third play of this opening drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 3.
Yeah.
from the gun. He'll hand this off.
And he will be knocked down hard, but he will have the first down. Defense had a chance to get off the field here in the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw.
This one complete to Jerry Jeudy.
And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 36. Hands it off out of the gun. And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out. And they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to get this pretty close to a first down. Stopped at the Panthers 28. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up. They'll look to throw here.
That's complete, Akure Bunam.
And he will have the Broncos first down by about a yard as they're able to convert on 3rd and 2.
That throw's not going to get them a whole lot, but that really didn't matter, did it? They got what they needed on that throw. Picked up the first down, and I'm going cliche here, game of inches, partner.
Absolutely. And you talked to me a lot about opening drives, how key those are to set the tone. You kept the drive alive. Third down conversion here is big.
And he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up 2nd. And possibly a false start. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. 2nd down and long. He'll drop to throw. And that is incomplete.
You definitely would have liked to have hit on that one because now you've got a 3rd and long showing up, and you just know defense is going to begin after. They are pinning their ears back, and they are coming.
This now play number 9 on the opening drive, but it's 3rd and long. Looking to throw. Flush to his right. Gonna go down. They get to him back at the 40. Danielle Hunter in there to get him for a loss of 3, and it will be 4th down. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. 3 points. Probably not gonna win this
Super Bowl, but at least you get something on the opening drive.
And it's certainly not going to lose it. So the bottom line is, come away with the points now, come back and get greedy later, and try and put it in the end zone.
On first and 10, Darnold flushed out right. Well, he's going to take a shot right away.
Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Michael A.J. Mudia.
What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
And some room to maneuver. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Well, I tell you what, when you get a running back who can move like that in the open field, that's something to take advantage of, and they certainly did there.
And first and foremost, this is all about vision. He can see the play developing right in front of him, and once he's past the line of scrimmage and got a full head of steam behind him, he's just going to keep right on going.
So an early 10-0 lead for him now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Fake to McCaffrey. Now Darnold. And going deep for Hill. Oh, wide open. Complete. Touchdown. Tyreek Hill. 76 yards. And the Panthers are on the board here in this Super Bowl. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And the lead is down to a field goal. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tackle and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a
touchdown, Broncos! Noah Fant, 75 yards! And the Broncos able to show off their quick strike ability. Extra point from McManus is good, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Faking the give, Darnold. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Off of play action, Darnold rolling to his right. Thrown across his body and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 29. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Bronco defense has a touchdown. McManus now for the extra point. And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away.
This is going to be returned from middle of the end zone.
Fresh off the pick six, it's Darnold.
And Darnold going to be intercepted for the third time.
He's picked off just shy of midfield.
Well, it's a cold night, and whether your quarterback wears a glove on his throwing hand or not, that ball is a rock, Brandon. You've got to really drive it through the cold and the wind, or it can take off on you, and that may have been what happened there.
Good starting position for the Broncos here as they come up first and 10, right at the 50-yard line. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. They'll look to throw.
This will be caught. Judy.
And all the way home for a Bronco score. Jerry Judy, 46 yards. And the Broncos are feeling good as they extend their lead in this Super Bowl. McManus's point after is good. And a rout is on here in this first half. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
And past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
An entertaining start to this one. More to come on EA Sports. First down, this is McCaffrey. And he's got it across midfield and into Denver territory. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side. and they pick up a first down, and that came out of the fullback position, but as you and I both know, that doesn't necessarily mean it's a fullback playing in that spot.
You know, times have changed, right? The old school fullback doesn't really exist anymore.
We're not getting that same player out of college. With all the spread offenses, not very many pro style, we actually have a true fullback. We're having to make do in the NFL and put guys in that spot who emulate it, but aren't necessarily that position.
Darnold, a quick throw to Anderson. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be third down. The play fake, and it's Darnold. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off at the 35. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
Well, we heard all week that they were going to put the football in the air a lot. The problem is that is now four interceptions, Charles, that he has thrown in this first half. How do you treat a situation? What do you say to your quarterback right now?
Boy, that's an interesting question, because a lot of it depends on the head coach and the people making the decisions. You have to know your quarterback and know if he's mentally tough enough to have a chance to turn it around. Or is he a guy that maybe you've seen enough and it's time to go to the backup? But right now what you're rooting for is your defense to help keep you in the game, to give him an opportunity to get back on track.
They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. Now a handoff as they run left side. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority, because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
They'll drop to throw. Completes it to Fant on the right side. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
And coaches always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
That's caught left side by Judy. And they snap him short of the first, as he can only get to the 20. And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the left hash, this from 37. The kick by McManus is good. And that will extend their lead even further. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field. And that's caught inside the 35. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. A big play there for Carolina.
But one thing's for sure, they're going to have to come up with something at halftime, because he is absolutely roasting them right now.
They're going to go through the whole litany of things, changing coverages, you know, what are we going to do to put a man on him? The big thing to me is treat it like a good pitcher treats pitching a game. Change your timing, change your location. So sometimes you're up on him, sometimes you're back. Just change up the looks that he sees and make him just a little bit more hesitant.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Now Darnold. And he'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up with a first and goal.
Throwing quickly, Darnold, that's complete. Touchdown, Panthers! Robbie Anderson, a 5-yard touchdown.
And the Panthers are able to cut into this lead.
There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
And they're going to get the two-point conversion caught in the end zone. And that cuts the lead a bit further. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it? Touchdowns.
So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three. Two minutes on the clock in the second quarter of this Super Bowl. We'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Now a handoff looking right. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a third and four coming up.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, but they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he will not get there as they stop him short right around the 34-yard line. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Boy, a call like this, certainly tougher to make in a Super Bowl, but they'll go for it on fourth down. They'll try and run for it. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
We're all still valiantly searching for the so-called book, right, that tells us what to do in every situation. Everyone kind of knows what it says, but it's never really been written down anywhere. He violated every code on that one, didn't he? Deciding to go for it right there.
Oh, yeah. Your side of the field, this stage of the game, you're supposed to punt the football. He said, who cares? I'm going to light the book on fire.
Yeah, analytics, everyone else, be warned. He's coming for you.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Back to throw here. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
I didn't like the look of that play right from the beginning. I thought he should have seen the coverage that was there. Tried to force it in. That one, he's fortunate, just fell incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's got his tight end fan. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45.
Good job there of getting his tight end involved, because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found him, and they get a first down.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Here's second and 10. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And down to the 36-yard line here. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. Ninth play coming up here on this drive. This is third and a yard. Now they try the right side here. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. He'll look to throw. And he's taken in by the tight end Fant. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10.
This has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And he's got his tight end Fant. Touchdown, Broncos. Noah Fant in the final seconds of the first half. And the Broncos are starting to open things up here in this Super Bowl. Extra point from McManus is good, and a route is on here in this first half. So not much time to work with here. 9 seconds remain in the half as this one is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And with only 9 seconds remaining, well, not much time, we'll see how they play this. A little bit of daylight on that first down run sets him up nicely. 8 yards on the carry. So we've reached halftime here in the Super Bowl as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
These two teams have had plenty of extra time to make their final adjustments, but time's just about up. The final half of the NFL season is upon us. So let's get it back out to our Super Bowl broadcast team. Here's Brandon and Charles.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And right now, their chances of hoisting that Lombardi Trophy not looking too great, but perhaps that long halftime, maybe it did them a world of good.
But there's ever a chance to regroup. It's in this game, right? Because you do have that long halftime, a chance to really assess things and maybe make some changes and true adjustments. They played great all year long. That's the worst first half of the season for them. They're hoping to put it behind them and come out punching here in the second half.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Darnold escaping the pressure right. On the run, he'll let it go deep. Right sideline. And incomplete on the deep ball.
They've been trying and trying, but they haven't sacked him yet. He's been able to get away and make plays. Tried to make another one downfield right there, but to no avail. They'll have to keep up the pursuit, though, and not let him get hot.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Play action. It's Darnold.
He'll get this out right here to McCaffrey.
And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Well, maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I'm wondering if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game because that's worked well. This offense, they have not looked particularly good all game long. But a nice throw there for a good game and a first down.
So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 46. Darnold will hand off to McCaffrey. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36.
50 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
Well, this has certainly been a nice drive with the way they've spread the football around. Here, they even get the fullback involved in the passing game. That's got to cause a lot of consternation on the defensive side. You've got to cover him, too. That makes things really difficult.
On first down, Darnold. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Hill. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10.
It is a nice pickup right there, and after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
Back to the ground attack here. It's McCaffrey, and he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Stephon Tuitt, the one that got him down.
Now, that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Darnold down to throw.
Open man left side. It's the tight end, Trimble.
And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown.
Tommy Trimble,
a 12-yard touchdown grab.
And the Panthers are able to cut into this lead as they score on the opening drive in the second half.
They're going to throw for the two with Darnold. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons.
It's interesting that when it comes to two-point conversions, even heavy run teams tend to throw the ball in these situations. In this case, this one was intercepted.
Yeah, they weren't fooled. They were ready for the pass, picked it off. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive.
And they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this is a unit that has to be itching to get the football again.
You can say that again. They've got to be pretty eager because, let's face it, they've had to sit through halftime, then sit on the sidelines and watch that drive. So you can bet that they're saying, let's get on with this. We got to go out there and get some more points.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10.
Throw right side is going to be caught by Judy.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a three-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
And now here's a carry heading left. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield.
110 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night.
Well, you certainly have to give him a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through. The pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Brian Burns gets in there to drop him for a loss of 13 yards, and it's also fourth down now. On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Fair catch called. It's taken in right at the 20-yard line. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football. Right now, I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for them. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
Third quarter of the biggest spectacle in sport, the Super Bowl. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Second and 10. Faking the give, Darnold. Looking for Hill again. This time it's complete. And this is going to be another first down as they'll make the tackle at the Broncos 40. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. Great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage.
Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. A big play that time through the air. 35 yards. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. In trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line, second and goal. And he's got it, touchdown Panthers! Christian McCaffrey, there to make the grab. Panthers are able to get a score back in the final stages of this third quarter. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and that cuts this lead down to 13. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Their lead down to 2 scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a first and 10. Now a handoff as they run left side. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Back now in Las Vegas. Welcome back, everybody. 1 quarter remains here in the Super Bowl. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second and 10. They'll look to throw here. And his throw here is incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and give the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here,
Guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete.
Well, normally you might say start running the football. You've got the lead here in the fourth quarter. But the way that they've passed it with such success, I don't know, maybe keep throwing it.
Yeah, I think you brought up something that goes against conventional wisdom, right? In this stage of the game, you would think you would switch to a running attack. But you're exactly right. They've thrown it so well throughout the game. And trusting this quarterback, I think he continued to do so.
Now a handoff looking right. Oh, he faked it with a juke. Now he's got some room. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
134 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on.
So the ball moves from 138 to the other as they come up on first and 10. Finding the open man, and that's Tim Patrick.
7 yards, the pickup there.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Working with a second and 3.
And now here's a carry heading left. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 4 coming up.
Some fumbles. They got one right there.
And it shows you how the game has changed over time. It used to be good enough for a guy to get a sack of a quarterback in the pocket. Now, if you come to the sidelines and you didn't knock the ball free, your coaches are upset with you. All right? So if you're a quarterback, it starts all the way back into you.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. A great effort there. His second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Broncos use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. And now the offense is going to stay out there as the Broncos will go for 2. They're going to try and run. And he is into the end zone again as he scores both the touchdown and the 2-point conversion to extend this lead. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Those Super Bowl hopes that they had really dwindling now here in the fourth quarter. That NFC crown that they got 2 weeks ago seems like a distant memory
as they have been outplayed tonight.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Off of play action, Darnold.
There's Trimble, the tight end.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. A fake to McCaffrey. Now Darnold. And he'll just get rid of it.
I kind of got to give him credit. Another incompletion there, yes, but he's still trying to make plays outside the pocket.
Yeah, he's been hemmed in for much of the game. How about him getting outside there? And that's what you want to see from your quarterback. He's not giving up on this game, so every other player on the field has to say to himself, I can't give up either.
Throwing again on second and 10. Darnold. And this is going to be another first down as they'll make the tackle at the Broncos' 29-yard line.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
On first and 10, Darnold. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Now off the bootleg, Darnold. And his throw is incomplete.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
And the Panthers are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Darnold. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
McCaffrey,
and he is in. Touchdown, Carolina.
Christian McCaffrey,
his second touchdown of the Super Bowl.
And the Panthers have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth.
Well, fourth quarter touchdown there, back to a two-score game, but time is not their ally.
No, it's not, partner. They still have a pulse, but it's probably a little weak right now. A lot of things have to go right in these final 2 minutes plus for them. I think they have to be thinking onside kick here, and we know how difficult those are to recover.
They'll look to throw. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Good positioning, and it's picked off.
And the Panthers are right back in this football game.
Well, as most teams do in their two-point attempt, they pass the ball. Instead, it gets intercepted. And remember, if you pick it off, you got a chance to take it all the way back to 2 points yourself, right?
Yeah, not the case here, but that's why you got to be really careful with those throws, especially to the outside. Try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30.
165 yards rushing for him now as his big night continues.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Here's a handoff out of the gun. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. So now the field goal unit trots out there for the third time tonight. This to make it a 3-score game late. And this is just outside the right upright. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. Now this one now not over yet, Charles. You've got a sliver of hope on that other sideline.
You certainly do, because that would have made it a 3-score game, and that probably would have been curtains at that point. But now if they can get down the field quickly and somehow get the ball back one more time, we may have a different ball game.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plopping.
And the Broncos get there and take him down. Second and 20. Darnold to throw. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete. Trying to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final two plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
Flush to his right. He finds an opening past the 40. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to be what we call a flatliner. Level in everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. It's caught inside the 25. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a look.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. The sack cost him only a yard. It's second and 11. Third and 11, and some extra depth in the secondary here. They're in the dime. Here's Darnold. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by Michael O.J. Moodie, and the Broncos are going to take over at their own 11-yard line. I think you and I were a little surprised back earlier in the game when he threw his second interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now 5 times?
It's beyond stunning to me, because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less talent. But a quarterback of his caliber, I can't believe what we've just seen.
Absolutely. If you would have told me this coming into the ballgame, I would have said never. Not in a million years, but here we go. And the Lombardi Trophy goes west, and it goes to the Denver Broncos, your Super Bowl champs. And their remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs, you see the guys sharing, the collective happiness. Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph. And congratulations to them, a fantastic season.